néhány pillanat múlva a bevonulással kezdetét veszi.
So with the procession, the Holy Mass is going to start pretty soon.
Szeszedetten vegyünk részt.
So let's participate faithfully at this Holy Mass. And we kindly ask you to lower the flags. And as for the billboards, please place them to your feet.
Tra pochi istanti, la processione d'ingresso ci introdurrà nella celebrazione della Santa Messa. Siamo tutti invitati a partecipare con fede e raccoglimento, evitando di innalzare cartelli e sventolare bandiere. The entrance procession of the Eucharistic celebration is about to commence. You are invited to participate with faith and with recollection in Holy Mass and to refrain from raising banners or waving flags.
nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Pax vobis.
Et in spiritu.
Beatissimo Padre, la ringraziamo.
Holy Father, thank you from the bottom of our hearts for accepting our invitation to personally celebrate the closing Mass of the 52nd International Eucharistic Congress. Since the time of Pope John the 23rd, Eucharistic Congresses, and especially their closing Masses, have been called Statio Orbis, a Eucharistic celebration that visibly represents the creation of one great communion around the table of the Lord. Today's Holy Mass is a very powerful symbol expressing our unity around Christ under the leadership of the successor of Saint Peter, with the bishops, priests, deacons, monks, nuns, and all the faithful who have come from all over the world. This ecumenical presence expresses our common desire for the unity of all baptized people. It is a special joy for us to have His Holiness Patriarch Bartholomew the First of Constantinople with us.
La presenza
the fact that non-Christians are present, especially those of the Jewish faith, but also those of other world views, is for us a living sign of the times. The Church's vocation among men to be Christ's ambassador to the nations. He himself, Jesus Christ, is the spring of living waters, fulfilling the eschatological promise of the psalm. All my springs are in you. Christ in us, Christ in the Eucharist, is the source of eternal life and eternal happiness for all peoples. He wants to reach people through our witness and our preaching, through our ministry of charity. He wants to reach the poor, the sick, the persecuted, those who are burdened by their language, ethnicity, or nationality, and all those whose lives are meaningless and worthless in the eyes of the world, and who are desperately seeking their way. Budapest is the city of bridges in the heart of Hungary and Europe. We feel it our vocation to be a bridge between East and West, between different cultural and religious worlds, between nations. This is why 15 years ago we, the members of the Hungarian and Slovak bishops' conferences, signed a document of reconciliation and friendship from which fraternity and mutual cooperation have developed. Many blessings also accompanied by the missionary cross, as it traveled through Hungary and the surrounding countries. The relics of the blessed and saints of our region made us realize that we can live holiness of life today, following the footsteps of the great martyrs and confessors of the last century. Alongside those who have already been canonized, we honor the memory of great archpastors such as Cardinal Stefan Wyszyński, whose beatification is taking place at this very moment in Warsaw.
Conserviamo anche con grande affetto.
We cherish with great affection the memory of Cardinal Józef Mincenti, a venerable servant of God, who gave an example of unbroken fidelity to Christ, to his church and people.
Intrepida fedeltà a Cristo, alla Chiesa e al suo popolo. Santo Padre,
Holy Father, accept as a gift from all of us present here today a copy of this missionary cross, which preserves the memory of the blessed and saints of our region. We ask you to be the main celebrant of this Mass, which we are saying in the name of the whole Church and for the whole Church, so that we may fulfill our mission in the world and for the world. In the person of our Master and Lord, Jesus Christ, who always remains with us, he pronounces the words of the transubstantiation of the Eucharist. Thank you, Holy Father.
Kedves testvérek, az ünnepi...
Dear brothers and sisters, at the end of this solemn holy mass, we'll get a pontifical blessing, which draws from the spiritual goods of the saints, and we'll have a complete indulgence. So we should confess our faith, we should confess our sins,
sának idején felmagasztaljon minket.
Fratres, añorcamos pecata nostra, ut aptissimus al sacra misteria celebranda. Confiteor Deo omnipotente, e bovi frate, che a peccavi inimi, cogitazione, verbo, opere e omnisciente, mi ha preghi, beata Maria, sempre perfetta, omni santi ostia santos, per vos frates, orate pro me, ad dominum Deum nostrum. Precibus et meritis beati Maria semper virginis, Santorum apostolorum Petri e Pauli, et omnium sanctorum, spatium vere fructose penitentiae, cor semper penitens et emendationes vitae, perseverantia in bonis operibus tribu ad vobis, omnipotens et misericors Deus, et dimissis omnius peccatis vestris, perducat vos ad vitam aeternam. Amen.
Thank you. Oremos. Respice nos, rerum omnium Deus creator et rector, et ut tue propitiationis sentiamus effectum toto nostribo et tibi corde servire, per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deo, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Dal libro del profeta Isaia.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord has opened my ear. For my part, I made no resistance, neither did I turn away. I offered my back to those who struck me, my cheeks to those who tore at my beard. I did not cover my face against insult and spittle. The Lord comes to my help so that I am untouched by the insults. So too I set my face like flint. I know I shall not be shamed. My vindicator is here at hand. Does anyone start proceedings against me? Then let us go to court together. Who thinks he has a case against me. Let him approach me. The Lord is coming to my help.
Chi mi dichiarerà colpevole?
Who there condemned me?
Um Domini.
I love the Lord, for he has heard the cry of my appeal, for he turned his ear to me. In the day when I called him, they surrounded me, the snares of death. With anguish of the tomb, they caught me, sorrow and distress. I called on the Lord's name. O Lord, my God, deliver me. How gracious is the Lord and just. Our God has compassion. The Lord protects the simple hearts. I was helpless, so he saved me. He has kept my soul from death, my eyes from tears, and my feet from stumbling. I will walk in the presence of the Lord, in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Take the case, my brothers, of someone who has never done a single good act, but claims that he has faith. Will that faith save him? If one of the brothers or one of the sisters is in need of clothes and has not enough food to live on, and one of you says to them, I wish you well, keep yourself warm and eat plenty without giving them these bare necessities of life, and what good is that? Faith is like that. If good works do not go with it, it is quite dead. This is the way to talk to people of that kind. You say you have faith, and I have good deeds. I will prove to you that I have faith by showing you my good deeds. Now you prove to me that you have faith without any good deeds to show.
Verbum Domini.
Deo gratias.
My only glory is the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, which crucifies the world to me. And me to the world.
Dominus vobiscum. Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Marcum.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus and his disciples left for the villages around Caesarea Philippi. On the way, he put this question to his disciples. Who do people say I am? And they told him, John the Baptist, they said, others Elijah, others again one of the prophets. But you, he asked, who do you say I am? Peter spoke up and said to him, you are the Christ. And he gave them strict orders not to tell anyone about him. And he began to teach them that the Son of Man has destined to suffer grievously, to be rejected by the elders and the chief priests and the scribes, and to be put to death, and after 3 days to rise again. And he said all this quite openly. Then, taking him aside, Peter started to remonstrate with him. But turning and seeing his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said to him, "Get behind me, Satan, because the way you think is not God's way, but man's." He called the people and his disciples to him and said, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it. But anyone who loses his life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it."
Verbum Domini.
In Caesarea Philippi, Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do you say I am?" This question corners the disciples and turns them around in following the Master. They knew Jesus well. They were no beginners, having been close to him and witnesses of his many miracles. They listened to his teaching with amazement and accompanied him everywhere. Yet, they did not yet think like him. They had not yet taken the decisive step from admiring Jesus to following Jesus. The Lord is still looking at each one of us today and asking us personally, "Who am I really to you? Who am I to you?" This is a question that requires of each of us not just a precise answer based on the catechism, but a personal answer that we can give with our lives. Out of this response comes the renewal of discipleship. This takes place in three steps for disciples. And we can do them too. We can follow these steps: proclaiming Jesus, making a decision with Jesus, and following Jesus. preaching Jesus. To the question, who do you say I am? Peter answers for the whole group or on behalf of the whole group. You are the Christ. Peter says it all in these few words, and the answer is correct. But surprisingly, after this recognition, Jesus bound them to their souls that they should not tell no one. Why this strict prohibition? May we raise the question? For a very precise reason, to say that Jesus is the Christ, the Messiah, is to be accurate but incomplete. We are always in danger of proclaiming a Messiah in the image of man and not of God. From this moment on, therefore, Jesus begins to reveal his Easter identity, the identity that we discover in the Eucharist. He explains that the culmination of his mission will indeed be the glory of the resurrection, but that to do so, he must go through the humiliating death on the cross. This means that it will all take place according to God's wisdom, which, as St. Paul says, this is not the wisdom of this age, nor that of the leaders of this age. Jesus commands silence about the messianic identity, but not about the cross that awaits him. In fact, as the evangelist records, Jesus begins to teach openly that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. This astonishing announcement by Jesus can astonish us too. We want a Messiah with power, not a crucified servant. The Eucharist is before us to remind us who God is. It does teach not in words, but in tangible ways, showing us that God is a broken bread, the love nailed to the cross and given away for others. We can surround it with many celebrations, but the Lord is always there in the simple form of a loaf of bread, allowing us to break it, spread it, and eat it. He becomes a servant to save us. He dies so that we may have life.
L'annuncio di Gesù. E chi si apre a questo annuncio di Gesù apre il secondo passaggio.
With this statement of Jesus, here comes the second step, the decision with Jesus. Peter responds to the Lord's revelation with a typical human reaction. When the cross, the prospect of pain looms, men rebels. And Peter, having confessed that Jesus is the Messiah, is offended by the Master's words and tries to dissuade him from continuing on this path. The cross is never fashionable, brothers and sisters. Not today. It's never fashionable. It was never fashionable in the past either. In front of the cross, there is a salutary struggle taking place within us as thinking according to God, and it clashes with thinking according to man. On one side, there is a logic of God, which is humble love. God's way is far from all compulsion, self-indulgence, and triumphalism, always seeking the good of the other, even to the point of self-sacrifice. On the other hand, there is the human mind, the logic of the world, which insists on esteem and privilege, seeking favor and success. Here, what counts is who is important and powerful, what attracts the attention of more people, and how you can gain an advantage over other people. Peter is blinded by this attitude, and he takes Jesus aside and approaches him.
Lo aveva confessato prima, adesso lo rimprovera. Può capitare anche a noi di mettere il Signore in disparte.
It can happen to us too, that we put aside the Lord in one corner of our heart, but at the same time we consider ourselves religious and good. We continue to walk the path we have set for ourselves, and we do not give in to Jesus' logic. So here is real truth. He is with us. He is a partner of us. He is with us in this inner struggle because he wants us to be on his side with the apostles. There is a side of God and a side of man. The difference is not who is religious and who is not. The essential difference is between the real God and the God of the self. How far he who reigns silently on the cross is from the false God we expect to rule by force and silence our enemies. How different is Christ, who stands before us in love alone, from the mighty, triumphant, and anointed messiahs of this world? Jesus shakes us. It's not enough for him to have a statement of faith. He expects us to purify our religiosity before his cross, before the Eucharist. It is good for us to administer the sacraments before the Eucharist, to contemplate the fragility of God. Let us take time to pray the Eucharist.
Dedichiamo tempo all'adorazione. Lasciamo che
We forget about it many times. Let's give enough time for this. Let us allow Jesus, the living bread, to heal us from our confinement, to open us to sharing, to loosen our rigidities and our self-confinement, to free us from the paralyzing slavery of defending only our own image, and lead us where he wants us to go. This brings us to the third step.
Il cammino dietro a Gesù.
To follow Jesus. To walk together with Jesus. Get behind me, Satan. This is how Jesus brings Peter to his senses with a strong, stern commandment. But when the Lord commands something, he is actually there in grace to help him do what he asks. And Peter accepts the grace and takes a step back. The Christian's journey is not a siege of success, but begins precisely by taking a step back. And this, please remember this, we need to take a step back. And this frees us from being in the middle, from being able to step out of the middle. It is then that Peter realizes that the center is not his Jesus, but the real Jesus. Though he still stumbles later, he comes to recognize the face of God more and more, forgiveness by forgiveness. And so he goes from barren admiration for Christ to actually following Christ. What does it mean to follow Jesus? It means walking the path of life with the Jesus-like confidence that we are beloved children of God. We walk the same path as our Master, who came to serve and not to be served. It means that every single day we approach our brothers and sisters. The Eucharist leads us to feel that we are one body, broken for the sake of others. Dear brothers and sisters, let us allow our encounter with Jesus in the Eucharist to transform us, just as it transformed the great and courageous saints who were venerated, such as Saint Stephen and Saint Elizabeth. Just like them, we should not be satisfied with little. Let us not settle for a faith that lives only by ritual and repetition. Let us open ourselves to the scandalous novelty of the crucified and risen God who, as broken bread, gives his life for the world. Then we will live in joy and bring joy everywhere. This International Eucharistic Congress is the end of a journey, but let it be even more a starting point, as the following in the footsteps of Jesus, it invites us to look forward, to embrace the transforming gift of grace, and to reawaken each day to the question the Lord asked his disciples in Caesarea Philippi, who do you say I am? For a couple of moments, please continue in silence our contemplation.
Let us reflect in silence for some brief moments.
Credo in unum Deum.
Pater omnipotentem, factum cælii et terrae, visibilio omnium, et invisibilium.
Omnes sub convenimus, frate carissimi, a redemptionis nostra recolenda misteria. Roguemos, ergo Deo omnipotente, ut mundus universus, isto cius benedictionis et vitae fontibus irgetur.
For Pope Francis and for all the clergy of your church, that for the salvation of souls they may carry the cross of their duties and with patience. That the leaders of the world may work towards putting an end to injustice and poverty.
Dominum de pretium.
That the sick may take on suffering willingly for the sake of their own eternal joy and the eternal joy of others.
Dominum de pretium.
Gib, dass wir uns nie über das
that none of us may complain of our cross, but recognize in it your holy will.
Dominum de pretium.
That we may help our neighbors carry their cross through acts of mercy.
Dominum de pretium.
Atsi Domine quaesumus propitiatio tua populo supplicanti, ut quod te inspirante fideliter expectit, tua celeri largitate participiat, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Thank you.
Murate frate sus me un avesum sacrificium acceptabile fiat ab Deum Patrem omnipotentem. Propitiare Domine supplicationibus nostris et as oblationem famulorum tuorum benignus assume ut quod singuli ad honorem tui nominis obtulerum cunctis proficia da salutem per Christum Dominum nostrum. Dominus vobiscum. Sursum corda. Gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro. Per digno et justum est, equum et salutare, nos tibi sempre et ubique gratias agere, Domine, Sancte Pater, Omnipotens Eterne Deus, a cuius immensa gloriam pertinere cognoscimus et monte, et ut mortalibus tua deitate succurreres, sed et nobis provideres de ipsa mortalitate nostra remedium, et perditos quosque unde perierant, inde salvares per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem maestatem tuam adorat exercitus angelorum, ante conspectum tuum in eternitate letantium, cum quibus et nostras voces ad ut admiti iubias deprecamus socia exultationes dicentes. Vere Santus es Domine, et merito te laudat omnis a te condita creatura, quia per Filium Tuum, Dominum Nostrum, Iesum Christum, Spiritus Sancti operante virtute, vivificas et sanctificas universa, et populum tibi congregare nos desinis, ut a solis ortus ad ocasum oblatio mundo operatur nomine Tuo. Supplices ergo te, Domine, deprecamur, ut ec munera, quae tibi sacrande de tulimus, e odem spiritus sanctificare degneris, ut corpus et sanguis fiam, filii tui, Domini nostri, Iesu Christi, cuius mandato misteria celebramus. Ipse enim, in qua notte tradebatur, accepit panem. Et tibi gratias agens benedixit, fregit, deditque discipulis suis dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes. Hoc est enim corpus meum, quod pro vobis tradetur. simile modo posco accennatum est accipient calis et tibi gratias agens benedixit dedicque discipuli suis dice accipite et vivite ex eo omnes hic est in calis sanguinis mei novi et eterni testamenti qui pro vobis et pro multis et fundetur in remissionem peccatorum hoc facite in meam commemorationem. Mysterium fidei. Memoria sigitur Domine, eius in fili tui salutifere passionis, nec admirabiles resurrectionis et ascensionis in celum, sed prestolantes alterum eius advento. Ustibi gratias referentes, hoc sacrificium vivum ex santum. Respice quesum in oblationem ecclesiae tue, et a nos hostiam quis voluisti immolatione et placare, concedi ut qui corpore et sanguine fili tui reficimur, spiritu eius santo repleti, unus corpus e unus spiritus inveniamur in Christo.
Ipse nos tibi perficiat munus aeternum, ut cum electis tuis hereditatem consequi valeamus, in primis cum beatissima Virgine Dei Genetrice Maria, cum beato Iosef eius sponso, cum beatis apostolis tuis et gloriosis martiribus et omnibus sanctis quorum intercessione perpetuo apud te confidimus adiuvari.
Hic hostia nostri reconciliationis proficia quesumus Domine a totius mundi pacem atque salutem ecclesiam tuam peregrinantem in terra in fide et caritate firmare digneris, cum famulo tuo Papa nostro Francisco, et fratre meo Petro, episcopo huius ecclesiae, et me indigno famulo tuo, cum episcopali ordine et universo clero, et omni populo acquisitionis tuie. Votis huius familiae, quam tibi astare voluisti, ad esto propitius. Omnes filiis tuos, ubique dispersos, tibi clemens pater miseratus coniunge, fratres nostros defunctos, et omnes qui tibi placentes, ec hos saeculo transierunt, in regnum tuum benignus admitte, ubi fores speramus, ut simul gloria tua perenniter satiemur, per Christum Dominum nostrum, perque mundo bona cuncta largiris.
Per ipsum, et cun ipso, et in ipso, estibi Deo Patre Omnipotente, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Preceptis salutaribus moniti e divina institutione formati audemus dicere. Libera nos quaesumus Domine ab omnibus malis. Da propitius pacem in diebus nostris. Ut ope misericordiae tuae adiuti, et a peccatus simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, spectantes beatam spem, et adventum salvatoris nostri Jesu Christu. Domine Jesu Christe, qui dixiste apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meam do vobis. Ne respicias peccata nostra, se fidem ecclesia tua, e anque secundum voluntatem tuam pacificare e quadunare digneris, qui ves regna in saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini, sit semper vobiscum.
Et spiritu tuo.
Engesztelődjetek ki szívből egymást.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Let peace be with us.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce Quitoris peccata mundi, beati qui accenan agni vocati sum. Domine, non sum dignus, ut intes in tecum me,
sed tantum tui libero, et sanat anima.
néhány pillanatig csendben imádkozzunk. Let's keep prayerful silence for some brief moments. Rimaniamo alcuni istanti in silenzio orante.
Oremus, mentes nostras e corpora possidiat quaesum Domine, doni celestis operatio, ut non noster sensus in nobis, sed eius preveniat semper effectus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Santo Padre,
Most Holy Father,
al termine di questo 52esimo congresso eucaristico,
at the end of the 52nd International Eucharistic Congress, the latest in a series that began 140 years ago,
noi rendiamo grazie anzitutto a Dio.
We give thanks first of all to God, who, as King of the Gospel Parable, has organized a great feast and sent his servants into the streets and squares of the city to invite the last to the wedding of his son. He has called us all together to the table of the Risen One to draw from the wellsprings of life. The Christian community here,
anche alla sua presenza,
thanks also to your presence, our Holy Father, shows its true face, its welcome and openness
di madre dalle
in the image of the mother with outstretched arms to welcome all men and women from all peoples and nations. Lift up your eyes and look about you, says the prophet Isaiah, all assemble and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters are carried on the hip.
To
you the riches of the nations will come. We all come here around the altar with our different cultures and traditions, with all the different ways in which we live our humanity, to renew a simple and powerful gesture of faith and fraternal communion. Today, with humility, the dream of the open door church, which you offered us in the first apostolic exhortation of our Holy Father, Evangelii Gaudium, becomes a reality. Now, this Holy Church, having taken up the bread of life and drunk from the cup, is slowly being dispersed to reach everywhere, like seeds in the furrows, opening new paths that form the mysterious fabric of the Kingdom of God. From here, Christians return to their homes, schools, offices, places of commerce, places of leisure, to share with others, to heal others, to uplift and help others, to reach out to their fellow human beings with the words of peace and acts of reconciliation. Today, the Holy Spirit of God, who quenched our thirst on this Statio Orbis, is once again instilling in us the courage to face the world as Jesus did. He showed us at the Last Supper that we are not to rule, but to serve. That we do not belong to the great of the world, but to the little children of the Kingdom of God. That we are not masters of things, but pilgrims. These Eucharistic days, which we have experienced here in Budapest, have shown us this path of novelty and conversion, because the celebration of the Paschal Mystery of Christ must not only enlighten the hearts of the faithful, but must also touch the world in which we live and work. The salvation that flows from the Eucharist thus becomes a Eucharistic culture capable of motivating men and women of goodwill to reach out to the Lord's poor, to prioritize the common good, to spread social peace, to guard and care for the created world, to be generous in ecumenical dialogue,
and to share in difficulties. In these and other similar signs, we celebrate the memory of the servant of the Lord who gave himself for us in the certainty that the love of God incarnate in Christ is stronger than evil, violence, and death. Based on the sacrament of love, this way of thinking can transform every Christian community, the smallest and the most inconsolable, to become bread broken for the life of the world, following the example of our Savior who gave himself completely. From Sunday after Sunday, around the altar of the Word and the bread of life, we are called to embrace the fullness of Christ in holiness, in love, and in mission. In this way, we can take upon ourselves the consistency of the Eucharist, which does not separate the body of Christ from the body, that is, it professes sacramental communion between Christ and the members of his body. Thank you, Most Holy Father, for celebrating with this great congregation the closing Mass of the 52nd International Eucharistic Congress, and for drawing our attention once again to this great mystery, which is both the source and the summit of the life and mission of the Church. We wish that from this city in the heart of Europe, from the Statio Orbis celebrated here, may spring living waters capable of healing Christian communities throughout the world.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Dear brothers and sisters, the Eucharist means thanksgiving. And at the end of this Mass, which closes the International Eucharistic Congress and my visit to Budapest, I would like to express my heartfelt thanks and my gratitude. Thank you to the great Hungarian Christian family, which I would like to embrace with its different rites, its history, its brothers and sisters, Catholic and of other denominations, all of whom are moving towards total unity.
A questo proposito,
on this occasion, I extend a heartfelt welcome to His Holiness Patriarch Bartholomew, my brother, who honored us with his presence.
Grazie.
Special thanks to my beloved brothers and sisters, my brother bishops, priests, monks, and nuns, and to all of you, dear faithful. Special thanks to all those who have worked so hard to make this Eucharistic Congress and this day a reality.
Nel rinnovare la gratitudine alle autorità,
as I once again express my gratitude to the state and religious leaders who have welcomed me, I would like to say thank you to you, people of Hungary.
Grazie a te, popolo di Ungheria.
The hymn that accompanied the Congress throughout the Congress says to you, and I quote, "The cross has been the pillar of your hope for 1,000 years. Now let the sign of Christ be the pledge of your better future," unquote. May the cross be for you the bridge between the past and the future, Religious feeling is the lifeblood of this nation, so attached to its roots. But the cross stabbed into the ground not only moves us to put down good roots, it also reaches up and extends its arms to all, to every one of us. It calls us to hold on to our roots, but do not be content with that.
Il mio augurio è che
to draw from the spring and give drink to all those thirst in our time. I wish you to be like that, grounded and open, deeply rooted and respectful of others. God bless you. May the missionary cross, the symbol of this Congress, inspire you to proclaim with your lives the gospel that saves, the good news that God loves all people with infinite tenderness. In today's world, hungry for love, which is hungry for love, this is the nourishment that every human being longs for. Not far from here, two witnesses of the gospel, Cardinal Stefan Wyszyński and Elżbieta Czacka, founder of the Franciscan Sisters of the Cross, are being beatified in Warsaw today. There are two people who knew the cross intimately. The primate of Poland, arrested and imprisoned, he was always a courageous pastor according to the heart of Christ, an advocate of human freedom and dignity. And Sister Elżbieta, who lost her sight at a very young age and dedicated her entire life to the service of the blind, made a happy example. May the example of these two beatified people encourage us to turn darkness into light by the power of love. Finally, pray the Lord's Prayer on the day we celebrate the name of the Virgin Mary. In the old days, you Hungarians did not say Mary's name out of respect, but addressed her as Queen. May the Blessed Virgin, your great patroness, for long accompany and bless you. My blessing from this great city wishes to reach everyone, especially children and young people, the elderly and the sick, the poor and the excluded. I say with you and for you, God bless the Hungarian.
Angelus Domini, Ave Maria. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus,
nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Ecce Domini. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus. Et verbum caro factum est. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Gentris. Gratiam tuam, quae sum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde. Ut angelo annunciante, Christi Filii tui, incarnationem coniovim, per passione meius et crucem, a resurrezione gloria perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine. Requiescant in pace.
Amen. Summus Pontifex Franciscus, Dei Providentia Papa, omnibus hic presentibus vere penitentibus, confessis ac sacra communione refectis, benedictionem imperciet, cum indulgentia plenaria. Rogate Deum pro Beatissimo Papa Nostro Francisco,
et Sancta Matre Ecclesia, et in eius plena communione, vite sanctitate, studete ambulare.
Domino vobiscum. Sin nomen Domini benedictum. Aetorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Per intercessione beatorum apostolorum Petri e Paolo, benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
Ite